Hiya, welcome to, welcome to part two of my Lil Lilith series. So we're moving on now to Pisces. For people with Lilith in Pisces, this is another placement where the runaway, rebellious Lilith meets a similar sort of energy to her own. Piscean energy is not rebellious energy, though it is often associated with escapism, swimming in and out, and with being kind of slippery. While I haven't put Pisces in my top three signs most likely to embrace Lilith, I think Pisces quite easily takes fourth place. Angelina Jolie has this placement. If you have Lilith in Pisces, you can deploy a whole kaleidoscope of tactics to ensure there's distance between you and the oppressor person or thing. You will start to zone out more through watching films, TV, looking through photos, playing computer games, even drinking and or taking other drugs, writing poetry, diving into some fiction, or simply closing your eyes to dive into some fantasy. Similar to the Venus in Pisces placement, if upset and suppressed, the individual may, at the drop of a hat, act like it isn't happening at all. They may spiritually shut their eyes to something, as if it's all just a movie that's going to move on to the next scene soon, or that will anyway eventually end. Different to Lilith being in the Jupiterian Sagittarius, where she will readily lash out with a physical, fiery expression that she will not be tamed, Lilith in the Jupiterian Pisces will react passively, quietly, and is instead absorbing whatever is going on. Though this is not rebellion on the surface, Lilith and Pisces people likely respond like this just as regularly as the Lilith in Sag person is responding, allowing them, the Lilith and Pisces person, to readily withdraw as a calmer defensive mechanism. Due to this fantastical escapist method of Lilith in Pisces, the individual will be pretty impervious when it comes to people or things trying to hold them down. Even if they are held down and imprisoned physically, they will have such a deep divine spiritual escapism that never fails, that will always kind of soothe them. Lilith in Pisces can also readily make the individual gaslight their oppressor. They will lie at will, and in dangerous cases, they delude themselves that nothing is wrong, preventing them from physically escaping when they may need to. Generally though, similar to having Mars in Pisces, Lilith and Pisces people may run away after giving many chances, but still without getting the desired outcome, after which they become wrathful and truly shocking in how they react. Lilith and Pisces is like, if you don't want to do your own dishes, then that's all right, darling. No worries at all. It's no problem at all. Sit yourself, baby. And then you're just gonna kind of turn on the TV and start kind of napping, zoning out mid-program, making it kind of water under the bridge this time. So let's look at Lilith in Aries. Lilith in Aries is perhaps a too unruly to rule place for Lilith to be, or it could produce an individual who refuses to sacrifice their originality and creativity despite the naysayers, with little regard for the polite. Justin Bieber has this placement. The Lilith in Aries individual may be highly childish when not getting their way. They may be very destructive when feeling pinned down, going on the offensive to possibly foolish extremes. While the individual is trying to lead and initiate in different ways, Lilith may too often sabotage these efforts by too easily causing the individual to be offended or to feel threatened or to be competitive in situations where cooperation is required. It can be excellent for artists, politicians, leaders, anyone who will be able to channel Lilith when their work and views are being attacked by haters, basically. It can make for someone very adept at cutting someone or something toxic off without a second thought. However, more often, Lilith in Aries people could spoil their relationships by giving up at the slightest sniff of boredom, running into the wilderness to hunt for someone more tempting to conquer. The cycle will keep repeating itself. And while the individual may build quite the empire from all their adventures, they might not be able to stop running away until it's too late, until they become too big for their own boots somehow, or they just burn out and lose inspiration altogether. Lilith in Aries people perhaps are likely to be very sexy or magnetic, unashamed to show off their prizes, unafraid to be the clown in a room full of dull and serious people. Could make them refuse to take themselves too seriously as well, gaining the favor then of both vocal and quiet admirers. Lilith in Aries is like, if you don't want to do them dishes, then whatever. But don't expect anything from me, you lazy bum. And don't even look at it. When Lilith is in Taurus, she is quite the reluctant rebel. Lady Gaga has this placement. The Lilith in Taurus individual has few problems sensing that they're being oppressed or abused. But like back in part one of this trilogy, when Lilith was in Capricorn, Lilith is sort of gonna engage in a more mundane crisis management, making a slow escape rather than immediately freak out. It's a bit of an uphill battle for Lilith in Taurus. She can really struggle with getting herself out of toxic situations and away from toxic people, especially if she was tricked or less mature earlier on. Lilith has to live in this Taurian energy that prefers the easy way out. Different to when she was in Capricorn, Lilith in Taurus also suffers from a need to keep things sweet and lovely, as well as a need to stick to different ruts and routines. This is all a difficult recipe for the individual to tackle, and in some cases they might never act at all to run away when necessary, especially if they are in a materially secure situation. Lilith in Taurus does very well when dealing with people or issues that don't really require rebellion. The individual will be very capable of taking things with a pinch of salt. They're able to smile and bat their lashes while not believing a single word of what someone is telling them. They're also not so interested in making an emotional or intellectual or violent scene over molehills. However, just like a bull pushed into a corner, Lilith in Taurus does have the potential to make the individual retaliate in violent ways, though this seems rare and will have been after a long time of being pressured to retaliate. Lilith in Taurus is like, if you don't want to do the dishes, oh, that's okay, that's fine, honey. But instead, inside, you'll be thinking to simply wait it out stubbornly, until you both have no dishes to eat off and the other person is forced to react. And that's a very Taurian thing in general. Like, oh, I think we need to buy more spoons. No, you just haven't washed the spoons, so you think we need to buy more spoons, but we don't. Anyway, when Lilith is in Gemini, she can make her mouth and her handle on data and secrets a very rebellious thing indeed. In the air sign of relative communicating and mental stimulation, Lilith in Gemini people have no problem walking away from dull people and situations. The moment someone seems narrow-minded or something seems a bit been there, done that, the Lilith in Gemini individual will happily continue to move on in life, constantly attracted to learning new things and finding new experiences. I might even say that Lilith is exalted in Gemini. Stephen Hawking has this placement. Similar to people with Mars in Gemini, if pushed, the Lilith in Gemini person will rebel and spill the beans. They will rebel and say what they want to say anyway. They will rebel by keeping their thoughts and their ideas alive, regardless of the obstacles. The Gemini energy produces a person unafraid of contradicting you if you've peed them off or if you've made them feel boxed in. This can make the individual really funny with their comebacks. It can make them a witty debater, and they can be the ones who use their rebellious curiosity to actually learn stuff that they take with them forever. And I think this can be a really great place for Lilith, allowing the person to frequently progress their mind and also their everyday circumstances. They will refuse to be bogged down by rules and will not take teachers so seriously, knowing that no one person or idea can ever be the be-all, end-all. Still, because Gemini harbors that infamous duality, for the other half of the time, the individual with this placement may just as easily detach and know that there's no need to rebel or to run away, since the element here is air, after all, making the individual want to remain in relationships, at least partially, no matter how messy. Lilith in Gemini is like, if you don't want to do your dishes, then how about you take out the trash instead? Or would you mind ordering us some takeaway? Or yeah, dishes are overrated, but could you pop the kettle on, seeing as you're in the kitchen anyway? And that will conclude part two of this Lilith series. Stay tuned for part three, where I will be finishing off the rest of the signs. See ya next time.